Oh my gosh.
Wayne Lennon.
I'm waiting back for Kelly's laugh.
Yes, yes.
Right, big one. Oh, what's the boat? Another one. Oh, that's nice fish.
Hey everybody, I'm Jessica with the Freshwater Fisheries Society of BC. I'm out fishing today on the Fraser River and I have just landed my biggest sturgeon I have ever caught. So I have this white sturgeon here. Lang, how big was it?
This one is 78 inches.
78
inches.
It's
6'6", right?
Yeah, that is for sure my biggest. So let's talk about a little bit of proper fish handling for this fish. So this fish is, of course, over 1.5 meters, so we did have to bring it to shore,
yes,
right?
Yes, we have to.
Yeah. And then let's say that it was smaller. What would you do in that case?
Okay, with a smaller fish, for me, I have a cradle. We fill it with water, and I do tagging with the fish, so I put it in the cradle with water, and we will process the fish by scanning it, and if it's been caught before, then we mark it down. There's a 13-digit code on the scanner, and then we mark it down, and then we do the fork length, and then we do the girth.
Right, exactly. Yeah. Hey,
she's almost ready to go.
She is ready to go.
Okay, so we pretty much we scanned this fish.
Yep.
It was a recapture, and we waited until she was ready to go, and now we can let her go.
All right, so let's release this sturgeon here.
She knows what she's doing.
Sweet.
Yes.
Now, of course, you want to get a photo with your fish, right? You come out here, you want to get that picture. What are some things that you should keep in mind when you're holding a fish, right?
Yeah, okay, so when a fish that's over a certain size where you have to go to the beach, you have to make sure the fish is halfway in the water, okay? The fish has to have the gills and his body supported by the water. You can't have the fish touching the bottom of the river just because it's such a heavy fish that it could hurt his internal organs.
Right, even just the weight of the fish
itself, exactly.
Right, is
exactly.
Kind of too much for its organs. Fish that are in the water are used to being buoyant,
exactly.
Right, and being supported, so mm-hmm. To pull it out. Of course, goes without saying, like, you don't bring a fish onto shore, right? Make sure it stays
in the water. Yeah, no
just
noose.
Like you said.
You know, back in the day, some guys were noosing the tail just to make sure that the fish didn't go away, but you know, that's a no-no. That's very, very bad.
Okay, what about the gloves though?
You know what, right? We wear gloves because of the scutes on the fish. It's very sharp. So with the gloves, it actually protects us from getting hurt by the fish.
Yeah, so this fish that we just caught had super sharp scutes, right? Unlike the one that we had caught earlier today, those were dulled right down. And as a fish, as well as a sturgeon, gets older, those kind of, you know, smooth out. So this one would have been a little bit younger, of course, than the fish we caught before. I also wanted to ask you a little bit about the gear that we use today, right? So barbless hooks.
Barbless
big
hooks,
deal.
And you know what? Heavy gear, because we want to tire the fish quickly. You don't want to be using less than 130 pound mainline and less than 130 pound leader, okay? Because you want to pull this fish in quick and let him go quick.
Exactly.
You know what I mean?
Exactly. And then with us that we were fishing today, as you get tired, like, you don't need to be a hero, right? Pass the rod off,
exactly.
Land that fish as soon as you can.
Exactly.
Right. Yeah. Cool. Well, thank you. I think we should get out there and fish for some more.
Let's go get him.
All right.
Oh my God.
He's going to come up and jump here. Keep it tight. Okay, we're going to see this baby. More pressure.
Do you want us to reel up 3-4?
Okay, reel up the lines, please.
Yeah. Okay, Jess, ready? One, two, three, go.
How come you get all the luck?
How do you get all the luck?
Should I put some drag on it? Is that really running much?